Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today let's take a look at how to use spell check on your Mac. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 500 supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you could read more about it, join us, and get exclusive content. So using spell check on your Mac is pretty straightforward. And best of all, it works the same way between apps, at least the apps that Apple creates. So here I am in Pages. We'll start there and learn the basics. I've got a few paragraphs typed here and I have three spelling mistakes. And you can see just by default it recognizes those are spelling mistakes and it has them underlined with this red dotted line. Now all the controls for spell checking are found under Edit, and then you look for Spelling and Grammar. And notice that I have checked Check Spelling While Typing and Correct Spelling Automatically. So let's uncheck both of those to start from scratch. And you can see when I uncheck those, no longer are the errors underlined. Now if I were to go in and turn on Check Spelling While Typing, it will underline with those red dots anything it finds that's wrong. Now that seemed to happen pretty instantly here with just these three paragraphs. It will take a little time if you say you're editing a book of 100 pages. Now you may rarely see this dotted red line because if you have Correct Spelling Automatically turned on, then as you type the words it will correct it. For instance, let me try to type this incorrectly spelled word here. And you could see that it corrected the word. Instead of a red underline, I get a blue dotted underline just to indicate that it changed something. But that blue underline will disappear after you type the next word. So this prevents spelling mistakes right as they happen. If you prefer to type without the autocorrection, but still see when there's a word it thinks is misspelled, then simply turn off Correct Spelling Automatically but leave on Check Spelling While Typing. Now if you have some spelling mistakes in here, you can review them one of two ways. You could go to Check Document Now or Show Spelling and Grammar. So you can see the keyboard shortcuts there are the Command key and colon and the Command key and semicolon. So in other words, Command and the same key but with or without Shift. So if I were to do Command and semicolon, it will jump to the next word that it thinks is misspelled. And I can continue to do Command semicolon to go through the words and it will loop through the document. So that's a quick way to check for misspelled words. If instead I do Command Shift and then the same key, in other words Command colon, then it brings up this little window here. It shows me the word currently selected and it selects it there. It shows me the correction, and sometimes there'll be more than one here and you can choose which one you want. So this is a more precise way to correct spelling. You can then click Change here, which will change it and then move on to the next word. You can see here it gives me several different options. So I get to choose what is the correct word. I could skip this by doing Find Next and it will leave the incorrectly spelled word there. I can also choose Ignore so it won't go back to it as it loops around through the document. I could choose Learn so it adds that word there. So maybe if this is a name it will actually learn it and it won't find it elsewhere misspelled throughout the document or in the future. And note you can set the language here. So you can just have it automatically figured out based on the words or you could set it to a specific language for spell check. Now you don't even have to bring up that window to see some suggestions. For instance, if I just put my cursor there at the end of the word you can see it comes up with a bunch of suggestions. So you can see it there for that word. You can see it there for that word. It seems to work when you put the cursor after the last letter. And of course you also see the same thing when you first type the word. And it appears there and you can select it or hit X to say ignore that. Now what's great is that it works the same in different apps. So here I am in TextEdit and if I start typing and you can see I've misspelled a word there. It does the same red underline. I go to Edit under Spelling and Grammar. I have the same options. I could use Command semicolon. I can use Command colon and choose from options here. It even remembers the words and will remember them across different apps. This even works in important locations like when composing a new email message. And you can see I have the same exact options here as I have elsewhere. I do have a little variation here in Mail. I can do Check Spelling While Typing, Never, or Before Sending. And this works in the Messages app as well. And you can see there it auto-corrected it If I go to Edit, Spelling and Grammar, you could see that I've got correct spelling while typing. I can do automatically, and I can even use those other tools as well. It also works in Safari if you're typing something into a form. And you've got the same options here. Now what if you add a word to the dictionary, like this one, and then you decide you made a mistake and you want to remove that word from the dictionary? Well, there are a couple ways to do it. One is you can select the word and control click or use two fingers on the trackpad, and then you should see unlearn spelling, and that will remove it from the dictionary. You can also edit your dictionary directly. To do that, in the Finder, choose Go and then hold the Option key down so Library appears. And then you'll be in your user library. Under there, you can look for a folder called Spelling. Go into that and you're going to see a file called Local Dictionary. Double click that and it will open up in Text Edit, and you'll see all the words that you've added. And you can edit this document directly, so removing a word from this or adding some. Now your Mac will change what you're typing using some other settings as well. So go to the Apple menu and then System Preferences and then Keyboard and then Text. And you'll see this checkbox here, Correct Spelling Automatically, which is a lot like the one we've been using. And this is in fact the default. But any app that you've set it in specifically will override that. You can also turn on capitalized words automatically, add a period with a double space at the end of a sentence. You can choose the default language for spell checking. You can choose whether or not smart quotes for single or double quotes are used and corrected. And then of course you have these replacements here. So something that you type will automatically be replaced using this list here, and of course you can add to that. But if you've ever wondered why, say, typing parentheses C and then close parentheses automatically changes to a copyright symbol, it's because the rule is here. So if you don't want to use that, you simply hit the minus button to remove it. Now it's going to be very different if you're not using an Apple app. For instance, Microsoft Word works completely differently. You don't find that stuff there at all. It's under Tools, Spelling and Grammar. It looks and works completely differently because, of course, Microsoft wants it to look and work just like it does on Windows. So keep this in mind when using third-party apps, although some third-party apps do adopt Apple's way of doing things. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.